So through the gospel passage which we heard today, Jesus gives certain replies to the questions which were raised by the people who were around him. The first one was that Jesus accuses the Jews of unbelief and challenges them to believe in his messianic and divine claims by truthfully assessing his miracles. Second, then Jesus gives the reason why the Jews cannot believe in him. They are not among his sheep. Faith and eternal life cannot be merited by man's own efforts. They are a gift of God, and the Jews are refusing to accept his gift from God. So he was stating, everybody has the opportunity to get saved. But those who are not facing to God or not turning towards the goodness, they are making their own after effect by themselves. Jesus gives the assurance that his sheep, his followers, he mean, will have eternal life and will not perish because they are protected by God, his Father, who is stronger than evil one. Finally, Jesus declares that he and God the Father are one. In other words, Jesus reveals that he is one in substance with the Father, as for us divine essence or nature is concerned, but he also reveals that the Father and the Son are distinct persons. Let us come to our life. When doubts about our faith haunts us, let us try to read more about our faith, to consult Catholic experts in our locality or on the internet, where we will find the Catholic answers, and to pray for the light of the Holy Spirit, that is the best method. And also let us find protection from the temptations of the evil one in the sheepfold of the church by frequenting the sacraments. The sacrament of reconciliation, which we have restarted right now, and the Holy Eucharist, now you can attend through the electronic media and receive the Holy Communion spiritually, and when everything is started normally, attend it. And by meditative reading of the Holy Scripture, when we are reading the Holy Scripture, we are not just reading that like a novel or like a newspaper, but we are proclaiming. When someone is reading the gospel or the Holy Scripture, we listen that as the proclamation of the word of God. And when we are reading, the same way we have to approach. And by personal prayers and also involved with the work of charity. Amen.